move in our bodies, move in our minds, move in our atmosphere. We need to hear your voice. We need to know what you want us to know today, so that we can have a right perspective, so that we can wrap our lives around your life. But we pray that you would come and move in our families, in our relationships, in our households. Come and move, Lord, in those things that might be broken, those things that might feel hopeless, those things that are a struggle. We're asking you to come and move. Move into that space with your power, with your truth. Lord, we're asking you to also move in our city in a mighty way, Lord. That the reality of heaven being opened up to us would manifest itself in the natural. The supernatural would begin to permeate the natural in this city. And that people would have a great awakening to who they are in Jesus Christ. That you would encounter them where they're at, and that they would find their true identity. That their true identity is not in their past or in their pain. Their true identity is not in their relationships. Their true identity is not found in anything but you. I pray that they would encounter you on that level today. That you would reveal yourself in a mighty way. Lord, we give you all the praise and the glory. We want to put you on high. We want to enthrone you over our day today. We want to say that you are Lord and King over our lives today. And we submit to your authority. We yield ourselves to the Holy Spirit. We walk by the Spirit. We recognize that this is not just about having the most comfortable life that we can or the most normal life that we can. This is a great adventure. This is a grand journey of stepping into who we are as a citizen of the kingdom of heaven and allowing the realities of those thoughts, divine reasoning, having understanding that this great thing is inside us. It's designed to become, designed to come out. It's not meant for us to just hold it in, camp out at home, and feel good inside. Is burning inside of us, Lord, but begin to be expressed through love on those people around us. That we would do everything with the language of love. That we would, everything that we would be do, would, that we would do and say would be done from the position of being loved and loving others. Today, Lord, we want to love you with all of our heart, all of our soul, all of our mind, and all of our strength. You're so good, God. You're so worthy, Lord. Spirit, come and move in us this morning. Move in us this morning.
I listen eagerly.
Eagerly
to all the wise instruction in God's word.
To all the wise instruction in God's word.
I keep his word in front of my eyes.
I keep his word in front of my eyes.
At all times.
At all times.
Until it is firmly planted in my heart.
Until it is firmly planted in my heart.
I have discovered the life-giving word of God.
The life-giving word of God.
It brings wholeness and healing to my body.
It brings wholeness and healing to my body.
Proverbs 4:20-22.
Yeah. Spiritual hearts cleansed in this fire, and yeah. Fire Cleanse out all that plaque that comes from us living in this plaquey world that we live in. And, you know, when I walk in here, it's like, oh, it's like heaven. Some of the plaque in me, I think I've expressed it before, is that condemnation. And I just refuse to believe that condemnation. And I take that beautiful robe of righteousness and I accept it, I put it on, and I believe and walk in it. And that condemnation is plaque.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
In trying to overcome trauma, for those that went, for those who didn't go, Christy had put up this chart, okay, of how the brain develops starting from the brainstem up. And they also went over about generational change, how changes in me will cause generations beyond me, okay? I was a drug user. I was not a very good mom. When I wasn't using drugs, I was working. Okay, so I had all that junk going on. So I go home Saturday after we finished. And my daughter's had to go to my granddaughter is auditioning for a singing part.
Oh.
So what song does she choose to sing? Jesus Take the Wheel.
Oh,
I made your, I
You can breathe.
You've always shown you are for us. From the time you orchestrated this extravagant plan to draw us to you, you've always displayed that you're for us. And what you asked for in return is that we're willing to let go of an old life to grab hold of a new one. To let go of wrong passions and wrong desires and take hold of new ones that are going to fulfill us more than anything else could. You say a lot of things like that. It's really the how opposite the kingdom of heaven is to this world. Because he says things like give in order to receive. Love your enemies, do good to those who hate you, and bless those who curse you. Oh.
Oh, So would you take it and make it?
lay it down at your feet. Would you take it and make it something beautiful? Break it, shape it into what you always wanted it to be.
Thank you.